In your teen years, you got the scholarship to go to Interlochen. And when I heard about that, I just in my head had this image of, you know, this person who's coming from a very different background than most of the kids at Interlochen. I mean, the kids that I know that went to Interlochen were very, you know, well off. They were taking singing lessons and music lessons from the time they were tiny. You know, it's very prestigious. I imagine that it's very kind of conservative in terms of how they train you. And so I just wondered, like, how did you stay true to yourself in this environment in which everyone around you was probably like, I don't know. I'm just imagining what that would have been like. Maybe it was totally different.
It was such culture shock. It was a very expensive school. I got a $5,000 scholarship. You know, I was a bar singer. I don't read music. I have no technical training that way. And they said I had to do a aria. And I was like, an aria? Like, I had no idea what the hell an aria was. And so there was a college in Anchorage, Alaska, and they had a music class. And I, as a 15-year-old, go in there and find this professor and say, I have to learn an aria. Can you teach me it? And so he had a textbook, I guess, of different songs. And, you know, he was like, this one's easy. It's in French and I don't read music. And so he recorded it into a cassette player of singing the melody with the correct pronunciation. So I learned it by ear and thought, there's no way I'm getting into the school. Like, I'm so full of shit at this point. But they accepted me. But I still needed $10,000 to go. And so I did my first little fundraiser. My whole town sent me off to school. I thought I'd have butlers. I thought I had grandiose visions of what $15,000 would get you at a boarding school. You know, I got there and it was just, I mean, I hitchhiked from Detroit to Traverse City where the school was because I didn't have money for a bus ticket. And I show up in a leather jacket and I had a large skinning knife on my belt, which is totally normal in Alaska. Everybody has a knife on their belt. Like, that's just, why would you not have a knife on your belt? So yeah, I almost got kicked out my first day for walking down campus with this very large knife on my belt. And the dean was like, where are you from? And I was like, Alaska. And he's like, give me the knife. Like, just, and bless this dean's heart, because I didn't have money for textbooks. I didn't know I needed more money to buy textbooks. I didn't have money for food at the cafeteria. You needed more money than the $15,000 tuition for food. And I had nothing. I was so on my own. And so I got a job on campus. I started modeling for the art class. And bless his heart, he really helped me. I got a gig off campus singing in a piano bar, which was so, I almost got kicked out for that too. I didn't ask permission. I didn't even think anything was wrong. I just went back about doing what I knew how to do, which was bar sing. To earn money. And he's like, we cannot have students singing in bars that are underage. And I was like, I guess that makes sense. But he let me continue. Thank heavens for this sweet dean. But yeah, I was a definite fish out of water. And my voice teacher ended up just being an incredible ally as well.